We disassembled the iPhone 15 Pro and compared it with the iPhone 14 Pro through the bitmap. Today we'll show you how to separate and combine this non-US motherboard. Furthermore, to share motherboard differences and repair difficulties, and detailed operation procedures. We checked the functions of the phone before disassembling. It's fully functional and can be used normally. Next, we disassembled the phone and started operation. Take off the screen. And disconnect the battery attached to the motherboard. Since the wireless charging cable has moved to the back, we need to unscrew and remove the protective iron shield. Disconnect the cable and take out the motherboard. We can see the iPhone 15 Pro switches the wireless charging connector and other IC components to the back. Next, we peel off the protective foam. Set the heating pad to 190 degrees Celsius and fix the motherboard on it. Since the middle layer of the iPhone 15 Pro still uses middle temperature solder paste for soldering, we need to add heat with hot air gun. Turn the hot air gun to 320 degrees Celsius, airflow 80, to heat the motherboard. Keep making circles on the whole sides of the motherboard, to avoid the damage caused by overheating. After heating the surface evenly for 30 seconds, insert the blade little by little till the motherboard has been separated. Remove the thermal grease on the chip. For a better view of the components distribution, we remove the cover shields. Protect the surrounding components by high temperature tape. Clear the glue attached to the shield and cover to avoid potential disassembly risk. Set the hot air gun to 400 degrees Celsius, airflow 100, and take out the shield and cover. Apply several solder flux to the motherboard. Clean the bonding pads with soldering iron and solder wick. Clean the bonding pads with PCB cleaner. Next, we start analyzing the motherboard. According to the testing results, the iPhone 15 Pro heats more than 14 Pro while playing games or movies. So, what's the reason for this problem? Let's start by analyzing the changes inside and outside of the motherboard. iPhone 15 Pro moved the NFC, amplifier, and wireless charging connector to the back. The new connector caused the distance between the motherboard and the back cover. Moreover, the heat dissipation sticker's position moved from the motherboard to the back cover, which is bad for cooling. Compared to the iPhone 14 Pro, although the position of NAND, CPU, and PMU almost remain the same, the logic board still overlaps at the top and the bottom, making it difficult to dissipate the heat. Although the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth modules return to the lower signal board, which alleviates the centralized heat to some extent. Therefore, the iPhone 15 Pro's heat dissipation performance is worse compared to the iPhone 14 Pro's performance. As the iPhone 15 series switched to a Type-C port for charging, we noticed the change in the USB charging IC. From the bitmap, we can see the same USB charging IC as the CD3217 in MacBook and iPad. If damaged, it will affect the power supply and touch function. If you need to replace it, we recommend replacing it with the new NOR flash. Next, we will show how to deal with motherboard combinations safely. Add several solder paste to the motherboard. Use hot air gun at 400 degrees Celsius, airflow 100, solder the shield and cover to the motherboard. We recommend to use 138 degrees Celsius low temperature solder paste. Because the middle layer of the iPhone 15 Pro motherboard still use middle temperature solder paste for soldering. Using middle temperature may cause pseudo soldering of components, which may lead to function abnormally. Apply the solder paste evenly on the signal board. Turn the heating platform to 190 degrees Celsius. After the solder balls are formed, turn off the heating platform. Add several flux paste to the bonding pad. Align the logic board with the signal board. Turn on the heating platform, use tweezers to adjust to ensure the precise alignment. Turn off the heating pad, take down the motherboard. Use air gun to cool down the motherboard. After cooling, reattach the protective foam. Install the motherboard for testing. The phone turns on normally. In summary, compared to its predecessor, the motherboards differ significantly in appearance. Compared to the previous model, heat dissipation would be worse, adding USB charging ICs made repairs more challenging. Relative tools for motherboard separation can be found on the detail page. For motherboard repair courses, kindly join REWA Academy. Thanks for watching.